Well, what's not to like about GaN? GaN is faster, it's smaller, it's more efficient, it's more reliable than silicon. What's not to like? So wide band gap really is, it's because there's a stronger chemical bond in the case of gallium nitride between the gallium and the nitrogen. The band gap is the energy it takes to pull an electron out of that bond and have it float around the crystal, become a free electron. So the tighter the bond, the harder it is to pull that electron off. So why is that better? Well, so what happens is if it's hard to pull off an electron, it means that the what's called the critical electric field is much higher. That's the electric field that you can apply over a certain distance before all the electrons start flying off and it breaks down. It's the spark gap. You know, in air, you have a certain critical electric field, then you get a spark. In GaN, it's the same thing. In silicon, it's the same thing. But in GaN, it's about 3 times higher than in silicon. And that means, it goes with the square of it, you can bring your terminals 10 times closer. So that means you can make everything smaller, especially at higher voltages. Now, when you bring things closer, you also have less resistance between the terminals. You make a whole lot less resistance. So that's why it's such a virtuous cycle with critical electric field or wide band gaps. It's a relatively immature technology, even though it's proven its maturity in terms of reliability and supply chain reliability as well. But every year we come out with about a halving of the die size for the same power. So just this year, we're coming out with our new Gen 7, just introduced here at PCIM, which is 1/3 the size of the prior generation. So it's a virtuous cycle. You make a device that's smaller, it becomes less expensive. It also has less capacitance, so you can drive it faster. You have less switching losses, which means that it is more efficient again. So it's a virtuous cycle. And then you make it smaller again, you do it again and again, and it becomes cheaper and cheaper and cheaper and faster and faster and faster and more efficient systems. So if you go to higher speeds, typically the passive components get smaller, the GaN is smaller, your PCB is smaller, it means it costs less to ship it somewhere. It's also more efficient, which means there's less heat to extract from it. So there's input capacitance and output capacitance. It depends on whether you're in a soft switching resonant circuit or a hard switching circuit. Hard switching circuit tends to care more about the input capacitance, where GaN is almost always 10x or even as much as 20x better than the best MOSFET for the same on resistance. You have a big boost there in hard switching circuits. In soft switching circuits, it's typically 5x better. And every time you shrink the die, the output capacitance shrinks with the on resistance, so it's getting better and better over time. So smaller die, smaller output capacitance, smaller input capacitance. GaN can be made to be radiation, not just resistant, but just impervious to radiation. But it's also, 100 times higher performance than radiation-hardened silicon, which typically is not nearly as high performance as commercial silicon. So you get 100x performance advantage plus no shielding required. And it's enabled new topologies to be used in space electronics, which further shrink things and increase the efficiency. So, with space, it's pretty expensive to throw a kilogram up into space. And so people really care about it. GaN is smaller, lighter weight, more efficient, and radiation hard. So, and it's not very expensive. So it's made a big difference in space. All the new satellite designs are using GaN for that reason. I think another area where it's making a big difference is in robotics. Robotics are, like humanoid robots. They have to not be too heavy. They have to be able to lift a lot of weight. And they have to do it pretty quickly with high precision. All those are things that you need higher frequency motors that have a lot of torque, but don't add a lot of sprung weight to the ends of your arms and fingers. So it's just all GaN right now for that reason. The power density one is AI servers. AI servers are getting more and more power consumptive. They're going crazy because for some reason we can't think enough. We need AI. And so these little tiny power supplies, are like 1 kilowatt. They're 23 by 17 square millimeters, and they'd be extremely efficient to keep that from overheating. Now, that's the kind of thing where you need GaN. You can't do it with silicon because the silicon device is just too big. They switch it to megahertz, and you know, they're 98% efficient. So that's an area where, and I like to say it because it's true, that if you use AI today, the electrons go through our GaN. So GaN fundamentally is based on a crystal that is much, much more strongly bound than silicon. And it's called a wideband gap semiconductor as a result. Now, because it's a wideband gap, as you go up in temperature, the effect of temperature is much less, because it does not impact thermal electrical characteristics as much, and it doesn't affect reliability as much. So, for example, if you put unlimited current through our devices, it can withstand a much higher temperature before it blows up. And that is something that is a robust factor. So we can show that, first of all, silicon stops being a semiconductor at 300 degrees C. GaN devices, you can operate happily at 300 degrees C. It's the rest of the circuit that doesn't like it. And as a matter of fact, it won't blow up until 600-700 degrees C. A lot of people like to compare the components between a MOSFET and a GaN, looking at the same voltage and the same on resistance. Now, between 100 volts and 200 volts, GaN is typically cheaper. So the notion that it's more expensive is actually not true there. It may be true at 600 volts, it may be true at lower voltages, but in that range, we ran a contest here for several years where we give people $25 if their part, their MOSFET part, was cheaper than our GaN. And 75% of the time, they lost and we won. We get to ring a gong when we win. Wasn't a lot of fun, but we still won 75% of the time. And so that's a false notion on a component level. System level, you gain additional advantages. Now we're moving that front down to 40 volts with our new generation 40 volt devices just launched at this show, where we have a 3x improvement over the prior generation GaN devices, which is also 3x better than any GaN, a MOSFET out there today.